afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is August 11th. It is Monday, and we are in the middle of a massive thunderstorm here. Wow, did you hear that? That was like right up the hill here. Awesome. So considering the stormy weather out there, what we're going to do today is something fun. It's going to be the top 10 strangest alternative medicine practices. Now, these are in my own opinion. I'm not passing judgment on the efficacy of these. I believe that some of them actually do work and some of them are effective. So, for what it's worth, here they are. All right, number 10 is ear candling. Ear candling is an alternative medicine practice claimed to assist the natural clearing of earwax from the ear by lighting one end of a hollow candle and placing the other end in the ear canal. It is also said that this practice can remove other toxins from the body. While I know plenty of people who do this, I myself prefer to stick with a Q-tip. Number 9 is phlebotomy, or bloodletting. Bloodletting involves draining blood from a patient to cure or prevent illness or disease. The logic of bloodletting was based in the theory of the four humors. And according to this theory, excess of any bodily fluid will disturb the body's balance and result in illness. One modern practice of bloodletting is for hemochromatosis, which is an excess of iron in the body. I myself was diagnosed with hemochromatosis about 4 years ago, or maybe 5 years ago, and apparently it has righted itself without me having to do any sort of bloodletting. Number 8 is cupping. Cupping is a method of applying acupressure by creating a vacuum next to the patient's skin using glass, plastic, or bamboo cups and heat. The therapy is used to relieve what is called stagnation in Chinese medicine practice and is also used in the treatment of respiratory diseases such as the common cold, pneumonia, and bronchitis. Cupping is also used to treat back, neck, shoulder, and other muscular skeletal pain. It also leaves really big hickeys on your back. Number 7, non-surgical breast enhancement. This one speaks for itself. And yes, that is a foot pump. Number 6 is the neti pot. This is a hygienic practice which involves pouring salt water into the nose. The goal is to clear out excess mucus and particulates and moisturize the nasal cavity. While it is rather effective, I just can't seem to bring myself to do this. Number 5 is psychic surgery. Psychic surgery is a type of surgery performed by a non-medical healer. The healer makes an incision by running a finger along the patient's body, apparently going through the skin without using any surgical instruments. And it gets even weirder. The healer then digs his hands into the patient's innards and apparently pulls out tumors. Some patients claim to have been healed from this practice. Number 4 is breatharianism. Breatharianism is a concept that its believers claim food and water are not necessary and that humans can be sustained solely by prana. Though I know many people who have done water fasts, I think that breatharianism is taking the idea a little bit too far. Number 3, self-trepanation. Self-trepanation is the practice of drilling a hole in the skull to cure epileptic seizures, migraines, and mental disorders. In prehistoric times, yes, that's probably where it should have stayed, trepanation was thought to cure diseases by letting evil spirits escape. Number 2, urine therapy. Urine therapy practitioners believe that urine has many preventative and curative powers, and this type of therapy has been referred to as the world's oldest medicine. Many who practice it believe that the urine can homeopathically treat or cure disease. They may be right, but you won't see me with an ice cold glass anytime soon. Number 1, rumpology. And yes, it's exactly what you think it is. It is also known as butt reading. Rumpology is the art of reading the lines, crevices, dimples, and folds of the buttocks to define the butt owner's character and get a glimpse of the future. So I hope you enjoyed that list. I hope you laughed a little bit. I hope that you, I don't hope that you got squeamish, but I know I got squeamish when I was researching some of these things. Anyway, what I want to know is, what have you done? What have you practiced? What have you seen? What have you read about? What are the practices that maybe should have made this top 10 list? Post them down below. I'd really like to see, because it fascinates me, some of the things that may defy our conventional logic. And again, it says nothing about the efficacy of these treatments, though I would say that self-trepanation is just completely off the deep end. But anyway, just post it down below. I want to hear what it is. One more thing. I want to thank John once again for this great t-shirt here. This is Pennington. Remember the blue guy I told you about before? This is Pennington. And the shirt says, I may be blue, but I'm for going green. And he's got a website. I'm going to post it down below. You guys can check out a shirt if you like this guy here. You guys can get one yourself. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.